السلام عليكم جميعا. Can you hear me now? Sorry for the delay. Okay, we are waiting because until now the participants number, we are expecting 60. Till now we have 31. So I was giving only a chance for other attendees to attend this orientation session. Okay. So again, another to remind you, please, if you want to ask a question, use the QA window, not the chat window. Chat window, use it if you have any issue with the sound or the slide or something is not clear from my side. But questions, please use the QA window. So Bismillah, we will start the second day of the orientation for Oman Summer of Code 2020. Again, my name is Khalil Ma'wali from Ministry of Technology and Communications. I have my colleague Huda also online. And today is dedicated for a session for online tools or the technical part of Oman Summer of Code to give you an overview. What are the tools which we recommend you use and why we are recommending these tools specifically. So I will share my browser now to change from slide to browser. Let's stop sharing this window. Okay. I hope all you can see the browser now. I will start basing صوت مواضح. أمل جسرية سيم. My voice is clear with others because I'm using the same mic like yesterday. Your voice is fine. Okay, clear. Please, Amal, maybe you need to raise the sound in your speaker. Okay, so I will paste the URLs in the chat window, so you can also follow me in the chat or in your browser if you you are opening now the internet and the browser in your PC. And I'm using headset. Saeed Salta, I'm using headset. Maybe you can see it, but I am using headset. So, Amal, okay. So I will start pasting some websites in the chat window so you can follow me in these links. Of course, we will also share all of these links and the details in slides to all of you after the sessions. So the first URL, you can see it now, I think, in my window. It is Ubuntu Linux operating system, which you will, inshallah, use for the next 3 months during Oman Summer of Code. This your website is directly for the version 18.04.4. LTS, the mean, why we are recommending LTS? Because it is long-term support. Linux is different than Windows. You need to understand this. We have more than 100 type of Linux. Ubuntu is only one type. So we recommend Ubuntu. Why? Because it is easier for anyone changing from Windows to Mac OS. Why we are recommending 18.04? Because it is not a new version. It's last now for more than 2 years. So we expect that it is mature, no issues in it. Aisha, maybe الصوت من جانبك من الانترنت لأنه مع البقية واضح. So if you are opening now this page in your website, you will have two type of image for Ubuntu. One is desktop image, and the second is server. Please use the desktop image to make your يعني life easier. And there is also 64-bit يعني version. We assume that all your PCs are 64 now. يعني it's rarely now you have 32-bit. And you download the image. It will be with the extension ISO. Then you need to install it in your PC. You will learn by yourself how to install Ubuntu Linux. We will share with you some courses. Maybe it will help you, online courses, free of cost. And you can learn how to deal with Linux as a start. There is multiple options how you install Linux in your PC. Either you use it with you format and you change everything in your PC to Linux, which we, of course, we don't يعني, recommend. You are not forced to remove Windows or Mac and use Linux. You can use Linux and Windows or Linux and Mac on the same PC without affecting your hard disk or RAM or anything in your PC. But you need to be careful if you choose this option. The third option is to use virtual image of Linux on top of Windows or Mac OS. And to do the virtualization, okay, Saeed Salti, version 19.10 is not recommended because it's not long-term support. You know, 19.10, it will end by October 2020. The support for it will end soon, يعني, because it will support it 1 year only. So we recommend 18.04. If you have 20.04, that will be fine. But it's not also يعني, recommended because it's a new version. Regarding virtualization, we recommend you use VirtualBox. It is the open source alternative of VMware. Maybe you know VMware. You are not supposed to use VMware because it's not open source. This is the reason. Not because it is bad or something. No, because it's not open source. We want you to practice open source tools. VirtualBox is a software provided by Oracle. And I know يعني, most of you know Oracle. You download VirtualBox either on Windows or Mac or even Linux. And on top of it, you put Linux and play with it. It is يعني, assumed to be very easy, but you need to read how you install Linux on top of VirtualBox. This is the second tool. I will share the website of VirtualBox now. You can view it and download it. You can start downloading it if you want, either for Windows or Mac. Of course, the best option which we recommend to install Linux is Linux with Windows or Mac, which called يعني, multiple operating system on the same PC without virtualization. If you are using virtualization and you have a small RAM in your PC, the performance will be bad and you will feel it. يعني, Linux will be slow and Windows or Mac will be slow. But that will be depending on your PC. The third tool or the website, I think this website is a famous website to you all. We expect anyone now doing programming or working with open source project to know GitHub. GitHub is simply a development platform. I describe it simply. It is like a Facebook, Twitter, but for programmers. So whatever you see in GitHub is codes. And if you are a team member of three doing a code in your PC, and you want to share this code with your team members, GitHub will give you that option without, of course, يعني disrupting others' work. So if you are three members, and member one do a code, then member two do another code, the third member also did another code, and then you merge it in GitHub, everyone will see how he contribute on the code without affecting others. And if something happened in the code in one time, you can retrieve it easily to the previous version. So GitHub is a recommended tool. You are not forced to use it. It is optional, but we recommend, and we assume that you already use actually GitHub. The second tool or second website is called GitLab. GitLab is the same like GitHub, maybe different features, but it is the same concept. What is the difference between GitHub and GitLab? GitLab is the open source platform. So if you want to build your own platform, your own business for managing source code, managing programming projects, for example, for government organizations or private companies, you can build your business using GitLab. You can install your GitLab in your PC or your server, customize it, do, for example, Arabic translation and simplify it for the users, and you can even sell it to them as a product. There is no difference between GitHub and GitLab. Only GitLab is the open source product for versioning tools. As I said, if you have any question, you can put it in QA and then I will see it after the session. Okay, video call tools. Of course, you have now multiple video call tools. From, for example, Zoom, which we are using now, but we will use this solution, which is Gitsy Meet. It is an open source product. I can open the website for Gitsy, gitsy.org. This is the gitsy.org, the open source platform for video calls. If you want to you build your product or your concept to have a video conferencing calls in Oman or in the region, you can use Gitsy and customize it as you wish. Gitsy work in browsers. They recommend to use Chrome. It's working with Android phones and iOS. You can download Gitsy application from Android and iOS, and you will use it. Gitsy customized solution was built by Omani company called Al Majmua Al Wataniya Lil Khidmat Al Amniya, National Security Services Group. They download Gitsy, they install it in their server, they customize it, as you see, and now you can start your video call for free only by putting a room name. So if you want to meet your team members, you don't need to register, you don't need to have account in this website, only put the meeting room name and use it. Good morning, I didn't receive any links. Others, can you see the links which I am sharing in the chat? Maybe Niranja, you are not receiving the shares. 1 minute. It is my mistake. It is my mistake. 1 minute. Okay. Now I think you received the links in the chat window. And you need to put this. But don't be afraid, we will send these links later to you with all the details. So no issues. So it was my mistake, sorry. Regarding, as I said, this website, it is the same as Gitsy website, but it is customized by Omani company. It is giving now free of cost, but as you know, video calls now on demand, there is a high demand for it. You can build your own business now using Gitsy. Okay, the other solution if you want to access your partner or team member PC remotely, you are staying in Muscat, your team member in Salalah, and you are working on the same project, the same coding, you want to help him, you want to access his website, this solution, which is called dwservice.net, is an open source solution to help you to go and access your partner website remotely through the internet. You need only internet in your site and internet in your partner site. It is working with Windows, Linux, Mac OS. And honestly, myself, I didn't test it before, but you can test it. It is an optional tool. You are not forced to do it, but it is giving you a flexibility now. So you don't have any excuse. If you are a team members of three or two, you can work from Muscat or Salalah on the same device, the same PC. Or if you want, as I said, sharing source code, you can use GitHub or GitLab to do that. The other tool, I think most of you know, Chrome Remote Desktop. This is another tool from Google to access your desktop from anywhere. I think it requires Chrome in your PC and Chrome in your partner PC. I didn't use it before, but it is another service or another tool to work remotely. As a partners, it is a free also service, but it's not open source. So what the difference between DW service and this Chrome Remote Desktop? DW service is an open source. I think you can find the source code of DWS Remote Control in their website somewhere. So if you want to build your own again business or remote control solutions for organizations, either government or private, DW service is an option. And you have other also options in open source. Chrome Remote Desktop is another one from Google, if you want to use it. Team Viewer, it is again another famous solution to access PCs remotely. So it is working with, it works with Windows, Mac, and also Linux. It is not open source, but you can use it. It is optional, يعني, again, for you. We recommend to use it if you want to access, again, your partner PC and support each other. Okay, the other now important platform is Zulip Chat. Okay, you need to know what is Zulip because we will use it extensively. Our plan is to stop using emails, and we think that you don't need us also to call us by phone. Yeah, this is what we think. Zulip Chat is similar to Slack. If anyone knows what is Slack. It is a team management tool. It gives you the abilities or features similar to Twitter and WhatsApp, but without giving your personal details. I will show you Zulip Chat, this page. You cannot access it now if you try now to log in by your, for example, Google account or something. You cannot access it because this page is restricted and you need to receive invitation. After this session, inshallah, all of you through your email will receive invitation to join Zulip Chat. Zulip Chat, and you need to, you put username and password, of course, to access it. Zulip Chat have mobile applications also in Android and iOS. Only you need to put this URL of the organization which we create, OS Oman Summer of Code 2020.zulipchat.com, the URL which I share. I will now explain simply how it will look when you access it. After you log in as a member team, I will now log in with my username and password. One minute, I will use my Google account. I hope it works. 1 minute, okay. So you can see now, I think, the window of Zulip chat. In the right side here, you can see users. Green, of course, it means that we are online. So you see two emails, Khalil Gmail and, of course, MTC. You can see Fahad, Huda, and also my name, Khalil Al-Ma'wali. So Khalil, Huda, Fahad, we are the MTC supervisors of Oman Summer of Code. We already have usernames and password to the platform, and we have the ability to the administration ability with all the platform details. As a user, you can see who is online or not online. So now we have Khalil as a participant in Oman Summer of Code, and also FOSS MTC as the administrator or the supervisor of this platform. Now, as a member, you will see in your left-hand side something called streams. Streams, like, it is similar to groups in WhatsApp. Now you can see a stream. This is the default stream called General, and also Team One. So General is our group chat where you can put your comment, your contribution, or question, everything, discussion, and it will be seen by everyone as supervisors, by us, and also by other members in Oman Summer of Code, as other participants. Under streams, under General, you will see something called, what is called, in topic. In Zulip chat, something now, they call it topics. So under streams, you will have topics. We put some of these topics as administrators, project ideation. If you need to install Ubuntu, supporting in installing Ubuntu. This is only for testing, we put it. Oman Summer of Code 2020 terms, if you are having questions, for example. And as administrators, we will add more topics in the discussions. Of course, you can add your own topic, but please don't put random topics. For example, I can now add a topic which is called technical support. If you want our technical support, and please, you can write, for example, please support me. And then, of course, you can use emojis and formatting and all of this. You can explore it later, preview, and then put a send. When you put a send, your now new topic will be shown here, called technical support. And it will be shown here, please support me. Of course, you can put your funny avatars, like my avatar here. And there is also multiple discussions. So this is only simply, as I said, groups and topics. Please don't add random topics in the general stream. Now, your private discussions, if you are a team member and you already you are a three group team members, okay, it is looks very similar to Slack, yes, but it is open source. This is the difference. So if you are a team member and you want your own private discussions, you will send us a mail. And you will say that we are now forming our teams. This is the names, the emails. As administrators, we will create for you a private group. For example, now this user, Khalil, have a group called Team One. where the discussion here is private. No one can see it. يعني. Even us as administrators, we cannot see what you are discussing in your group. And I will show you يعني, by proof. So you need to trust that we cannot see unless you request us. If you request our as a supervisor to be involved in your team private discussions, we can do that. But we cannot do that without your permission. This is to understand. And you need to know that Zulib also support Arabic, as you said. So we have now a stream called Team 1. There is a topics called المناقشة التقنية in Arabic, discussion project idea. If you want to discussion the project idea with your team, this stream is for events, only for testing we put it. As I said, you can write in Arabic. So let me add something here on the topic. Okay, without topic. I can, for example, reply to this discussion. Collapse mode, copy, where is the reply? Ah, okay, reply. This is the reply, I missed it there. So I will put marhaba, for example, Khalil bil Arabi. So you can discuss in Arabic. You can attach, for example, photos, and it will be loaded. Please don't attach big files because we have limitation on the server in Zulib chat on these files. If it is full, as an administrators, we will remove the higher size يعني, files. You can, as I said, photo, you can add, for example, a PDF file. It is added there. You can share a video call, a video link from YouTube, document, Word, Excel, PDF, as is seen here. And when you click it, of course, from your browser, it will be opened in your browser in Zulib chat. Okay. And as you see, this is what is called night mode in Zulib chat, the colors. It is like a night mode in Zulib chat. If you want to discuss your project idea, you create your own stream. And under this, and you can add, of course, a new stream as a member. Or let's try. I think you cannot create as a member a stream. Yes, as a attendee, you cannot add streams. Only what you can add is a topic. You can add a topic under your. For example, new topic under your stream. So let's have fun. And you put we will go for a trip. Yeah, even though we have Corona, but I will put it's only for fun. So you can put, as I said, streams, and you, sorry, a topic. You can add a topic under your stream, your group, and you start discuss here. I hope it is clear يعني, and easy يعني, tool. There is also options for notifications. يعني, there is a lot of settings here. You can explore it by yourself, notifications, in the Zulib chat also have desktop applications for Windows, for Mac, for Linux. I install it in my now Linux, but you can also use it in your browser, in your phone, and you customize the notification as you like. There is one note that you cannot initiate a private message. For example, if I want now to send a private message to Khalil Al-Ma'wali, which is me as a supervisor for Oman Summer of Code, you will see that it will not be sent. Private messages in this group in Oman Summer of Code is not allowed. Why? because we want your questions to be public for everyone. So if you are asking for help in installation Ubuntu, don't send a private message to me or Fahad or Huda. And also, please don't send messages to FOSS MTC. This FOSS MTC is the super admin in Zulip chat. You can communicate to me, Khalil, or Huda and Fahad. It is very easy. You can put reply at like WhatsApp and Twitter, and you will see my name, Khalil. Please help. Put send, and I will get a mention and a notification. I don't know if but I see notification even in my desktop. Now to be transparent with you. This is my account in Zulip chat as a supervisor. As you see, I have a stream called General, which is public for everyone. Core team, which is for me and my colleague Fahad and Huda only to discuss. And team two, I was only testing to put myself in team two. I don't have access to team one. So you can see that team one here is not appearing to my account in team two. We have the full control on Zulip chat. As you said, for example, mentions. Now, if someone mentioned me, I can find it here. This is FOSS MTC, not okay. Private messages is not allowed, and we disable it by ourselves. One idea: Zulip chat is open source, so it's similar to Slack. As I said, if someone test Slack before, if you want to you build your own business around Zulip chat, you can do it. Zulip chat have capabilities. It can be deployed in the government or private. It have also integration with Gitsy, so you can have a video call, but you need to know that the video call of the default Gitsy is not working in Oman. We don't know the reason, but it's blocked in Oman. So the alternative way is to use this solution. So this is, in short, the tools which are recommended to be used by you. I don't see any questions. I hope you understand and everything is clear with these tools and why you need it. So please, if you have any questions, put it in QA window. One last website, which is this website. It's our work, which we did, is only for your reference. So this project is one of our projects with Sultan Qaboos University. It's called OpenDVD. It's as described in the website, collection of free and open source softwares in different areas: education and games, productivity, internet, books and media, and everything, different areas. These softwares are this website is to make for the users, the new users, especially in Windows, for Windows users, how they can reach open source tools easily for Windows. So all these packages which you see in this website is for Windows, but it is applicable. It can be also installed in Mac and Linux, but not from this website. This website, the softwares are all for Windows. Why I am showing you this OpenDVD, because there is a section called books. If you want to explore more about open source, about Linux and all of these things, you can review them here. And most of them are in Arabic, but if you want also support, there is websites for Ubuntu, Stack Overflow, I think it is famous with you. Other Linux also sites and Ubuntu forms. This is only for your reference, this website. Now regarding Okay, I have question here. Can you please briefly in short reply the needed apps to be installed? I lost my internet connection for around 20 minutes. Okay, we will share all of these slides and the websites with you in one file. But in short, the most needed website now, and it's not optional, is using Linux, and we recommend Ubuntu 18.04. How you install it and how you will deal with it, it will be your task, but you need Linux to be installed. Can you please raise your voice a bit? Well, I'm trying, Ahmed Al-Aqmi, I'm trying to do that, but it's not easy. Okay, I hope my voice is clear. If you have another question, please put it here. So I will share with you now some courses is online, so you can explore it. I think most of you know nedras.com website, which is e-learning or e-learning website, and you can get courses is online. If you go to nedras.com, it is in Arabic. So I will explain it in Arabic now. Then I will share some courses in English. موقع ندرس طبعا في دورات متخصصة في كثير من المجالات. لو زرتوها في كورسين يخصوا لينكس هنا موجودات. مقدمة في لينكس أبونتو للمبتدئين مجانية يقدمها الأخ فادي الأسودي. You can join it. طبعا احنا وي ريكومند احنا ننصح انك تبدا بلينكس ابونتو للمبتدئين. من ثم في مقدمه للينكس لكن هذه مور ادفانس من للمبتدئين. وذي ار فري. اي جروب او اي ممبر جوين هذه الدورات واخذ على سبيل المثال الشهاده، طبعا في شهاده تصدر من ندرس في بعد الكورس. اي حد يدخل الدورة ويحصل على الشهادة هذا يعتبر added value له في الإيفالويشن. أتمنى أنه الجميع يدخل هذه الكورسات، بخاصة اللي ما جال يتعامل مع لينكس ولا أبونتو من قبل بتاتا. فكل ما دخلت كورسات تخص الأوبن سورس في خلال صيف عمان للبرمجة، كل ما كان الإيفالويشن مالك أنت أسهل أول شيء. ثاني شيء بنعمل لك flexibility أكثر من البقية، لانه طبعا هذا يدل انك انت عندك كوميتمنت في خلال المشروع. بنحاول احنا الحين نحاول ان نقدم كورسات مجانيه لجميع المشاركين في صيف عمان للبرمجه، لكن بسبب الوضع الراهن ما قادرين نعطيكم طبعا الكونفرميشن في هذا الوضع. فانا برسل لكم الرابط الحين مال الكورسات في الشات، وتقدروا تدخلوا على هذه الكورسات مع لينكس في ندرس.com. بالنسبة للكورسات باللغة العربية بس بحتاج لحظات دقيقة، لأنه في رابط كان حصلته من زميلي. فلحظات جميل. أوكي، هذا الرابط الأول. أوكي، you have another course from edx.org. It's called Introduction to Linux from Linux Foundation. Everyone who knows Linux, they should know Linux Foundation. Linux Foundation, which is behind the Linux project. This is an introduction. You need, of course, to enroll yourself. The next enrollment will be today. So it is there. Of course, it is a long course, 14 weeks, and the price for this website is, for the course is free. But if you want a certificate, you need to pay, of course. هي international certification. The other course from Coursera. In Linux. First, let me share this link in the chat. حورية حورية أنت تقولي تو أنا وحدي ما يظهر عندي الرسائل ولا أسئلة ولا حد معي. لا ما تظهر معك أعتقد في زوم ما يظهر الرسائل والأسئلة، بس أنت إذا سألتي توصل عندي أنا ك يعني الشخص اللي يراجع الأسئلة والنقاش. هذا كيف زوم يظهر. I share the edX course for Linux now the URL. The second course is Coursera. Coursera also giving Linux server management and security. It is more advanced يعني course. I think it is free. I don't know where to find that free, but I think it is free course from Coursera. Yes, enroll for free. So we recommend you to join these courses. Please. مازن المعمري أنا أرسل الروابط. أنت ما يوصل لك الروابط؟ ولا أنا؟ أوكي. ما أعرف الروابط يمكن ما وصلت. أرسلها مرة ثانية. So ما تظهر روابط آخر شيء. أوكي مرة ثانية هذا الخطأ مني أنا لأنني يمكن ما كنت أسوي شير للجميع. بس أوكي في نهاية السيشن بسوي أوكي أربعة وصلنكم. أنا فهمت السبب لأنه ما كان ترسل حال للجميع. في نهاية السيشن برسل كل الروابط مرة واحدة. وطبعا we will share it by email بعد. مرة ثانية these courses from Coursera and edX is recommended to be attended by you. So now I will copy paste all URLs في الشات. والله زوم is tricky يعني. Okay, this is the first one. I hope you are now receiving them يعني all. GitHub and GitLab. All panel attendees. Okay. So I think you are seeing now the URLs coming or not. Can anyone confirm that you are receiving URLs in the chat? Okay, yes. Thank you, Khulud. Okay, the team viewer URL. Okay. For Zulip chat link, I will not share it because you will get invitation in your email to join, because now you cannot join without invitation. Okay, Jitsi. And the link for the courses is from Nedros. This is in Arabic. edX course in Linux in English. I have copy a minute. And the last one is Coursera. Okay. I hope you receive all the URLs. Okay, questions. I am now going to answer questions. Okay, Mahmoud Al-Rashdi, may I ask what courses for Python or Linux programming at Coursera, edX, and Udemy? There are no current courses to deal with this. What do you recommend? Mahmoud, did you receive the link from Coursera? There is now a Coursera. I already show. I hope you see this page. It is Coursera course, Linux server management and security. So we already share Linux courses, two in Arabic, two in English. Okay, anonymous attendee. Do we have to do both the courses on edX and Coursera, or is any one of them is fine? If it is fine, any of them, we recommend both because edX course is more on of introduction. But Coursera course is more advanced. So we recommend both. Okay. Mahmoud, it's fine. Anyone have any other question? Either for today's session or yesterday session. So I hope now you know how يعني you will be dealing with Zulip chat, this window, to discuss and form teams. We don't recommend to you share your personal details in the general stream and general discussions. Unless you want to have, يعني, for example, if you want to have a video call, you can share the link in Zulip chat, and then you go in a private discussion with your maybe selected team members. If you want to share your email address in Zulip chat, it's fine for us. If you want to share also your mobile number, it is fine, but we don't recommend. It is at the end your decision. As I said, the general stream in Zulip chat is public. Anyone can see what is written there. Your private discussions will be after you share with us your team members details. So now I am opening, waiting for questions. If you have any questions, Huda, إذا كنت معي تريد تضيف شيء, Huda.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله, كيف الحال جميعاً؟ الإضافة الوحيدة اللي أريد أضيفها إنه من أمس جلسة توصلنا إيميلات عن طريق الإيفنت تيم معانا في الوزارة. المتسابقين يدخلوا هناك يرسلوا إيميلاتهم واستفساراتهم. فبس أتمنى إنكم ترسلوا الاستفسارات والإيميلات دايركت لمعانا إحنا عن طريق إيميل أو في زولي.
Okay, so now I'm sharing our mail in the chat for everyone. fos@ita.gov.one, which is will be received by me and Huda and my colleagues. So please use this email if you want to contact us. بس Huda, يعني إحنا I expect إنه after the participants join Zulip chat, we will not use the email.
أفضل أيوة. إحنا رح نعتمد على الزولب ونكون دائما متابعين ومشتغلين على الزولب. أفضل.
Okay. Okay. I have two questions now, not answered. لؤي العزري, can we use Raspberry Pi for the project? It has operating system called Raspbian, which is one of Linux distribution. لؤي, yes. يعني if you want to make your difficult, يعني your life more difficult, it is fine with us. Use Raspberry Pi and Raspbian, but be careful that before you start your project, we need to review your project idea, your project plan, why you are using, for example, Raspberry Pi. يعني. Is it only to avoid using and disturbing your laptop, or you are using it for example, IoT project, or I don't know, artificial intelligence tools, or I don't know. For Raspberry Pi. So yes, you can use the Raspberry Pi. Provide us with the email so we can send our details. Haja, for me, I don't know any participants in the Summer of Code to form a group. Haja, as I explained, to form a group and you know the participants, you will join the Zulip chat, you will receive invitation. You will need the username and password. You will join with others. You can introduce yourself in the discussion, and you form a team after you know the participant. You can have even a video call by yourself, يعني, with them. أفلح المزروع, I'm using Ubuntu 16.04. Is it good? أفلح, you are, يعني, ما شاء الله, يعني, still old. 16.04, it is fine, but you need to know that it will be out of support next year on April. It is fine for us if you are using 16.04. We don't recommend it because يعني, it will be out of date after 1 year. يعني. That's only why we don't recommending it. Any other question? If maybe we didn't see any question. Okay, Saeed Salsi, is it ITA or MTC? No, no, ITA. For this, so for this email, still we are ITA because our IT team still not migrate. They didn't migrate this address. So it's still ITA. And I think you already received emails from fos@ita.gov.on when we were sharing the online test, your results and the communication. We were using this email. Please, can you repeat how to use Zulip chat? Rehab al-Kalbani. Wallahi, Rehab, it's not easy to repeat. What I recommend, you will receive invitation in your email. You join Zulip chat and try it by yourself.
It is,
okay.
تشوف recorded هذا السيشن.
Yes, صح. احنا, we are recording this session and we will upload it in YouTube and we will share the link so you can review it also. It will be archived. But Zulip chat is very easy. It's simpler. It's same like Twitter and WhatsApp. I already explained this. Okay, Saeed. Thank you. We are making your life difficult too. Anonymous attendee. Wallahi, I cannot comment on this. But inshallah, we will have a long and very interesting journey for the next 3 years. Three months. Sorry. So to make our life difficult, this is fine for us. This is our job. We are doing this project since 2013, so it's not something new. Anyone have any question? Okay, Hamdan. Hamdan Salahi, I installed already Ubuntu 20.04. Can I keep going on this? Hamdan, yes, you can keep going. What can I say? You can use version 20, but you need to know that it's new version, so you may face some issues. Not a big issues, but because it's a new version. Muhammad Al-Haddabi, I just want to point out that I sent an email yesterday regarding some points about my project. Not sure if you receive it or not. Muhammad, we receive your email and we will reply to you. Anonymous attendee, when you are going to share this session on YouTube, hopefully today or tomorrow, inshallah, maximum. Any other question? Something? Okay. Amir Dghishi, كيف نتناقش في أفكار المشاريع مع حفظ حقوق الفكرة؟ ما حد يشل الفكرة ويطورها؟ والله يا أمير هذا السؤال غير قابل للإجابة. خبرني إيش معنات حقوق الفكرة؟ ما في حاجة أنا سمعت عنها عالميا وعن حاجة اسمها حقوق الفكرة. الأفكار اللي أنا اللي أعطيتكم إياها أمس هذيك مش تعتبر أفكار، واللي اليوم طرحتها لكم وأنا جالس أتناقش مع هذا السولوشنز مش أفكار. فليش أنت تتحدث عن حقوق الفكرة؟ الفكرة أي حد ممكن إنه ينجزها. فإحنا ما نقدر على سبيل المثال نقول إنه ممكن نحافظ على الفكرة. الديسكشن هذا الجنرال اللي إحنا حطيناها ليش؟ عشان لما واحد يجي ويحط فكرة إنه يريد يعمل على سبيل المثال تطبيق لوزارة الصحة يا أمير، لنفترض كذا. وجينا احنا كفريق في الوزارة أبدينا رأينا وقلنا له انه في تحديات وفي غيره، لان احنا نعرف اشياء كثيرة في وزارة الصحة صايرة. يجيني بعدين فريق او فريقين او ثلاثة فريق افريقا يجيبوا نفس الفكرة تخص وزارة الصحة، انا اريدهم كلهم يسمعوا الكلام مرة واحدة. لذلك انا اقول انه مناقشة افكار المشاريع في طريقة طبعا مع التيم في زوليب تشات، لما تناقش الفكرة في الجنرال هذه معنا احنا مع الفريق مع الوزارة. اذا تريد مناقشة الفكرة مع الفريق مالك انت، في نعمل لك جروب وتناقشوا الفكرة مثل ما تريدوا بدون ما حد يطلع عليها، لا احنا في الفريق الوزارة ولا المشاركين الثانيين. هذا الجواب باختصار. Okay, anonymous attendee, I do have a VBS. Is it fine to use it install of using my PC? Okay, if you are using VBS, it needs to have Linux below it. That's it. and you can use it. Yes, we recommend actually to use VBS. Wallahi, I don't know if it is paid or free. Yani this VBS, it will be good to have free VBS. If anyone doesn't know what is VBS, it is virtual private server. It is paid. I think there are some free VBS. Yani you can have your own server online for free for limited time, for example, 1 month or 2 months. It will be good to if you want to use VBS. Yani, I recommend actually to use VBS. It will be more flexible for the team. Allow private messages so we can discuss our project. No. We cannot allow private messages because of our regulations. We will allow private discussion after you form the team only. After you form the team, you can have your private discussion. And we don't want to have private messages. Why? Because we as organizers, if you send a message to me as our organizer, which is a private, our colleague, for example, Huda and my team, Fahad, other team members, they will not see the private message. And if I am in, for example, in vacation or I'm not in the world, who will reply to you? Yani? This is why we are blocking the private messages now. Okay. Ahmed Al-Ajmi, can I use VM in Amazon Web Services or Microsoft Azure? Yes, you can use it, but as I said, you will need the Linux on top of that virtual machine. Yani in Amazon or Microsoft, they provide also Linux machines on top of it. I hope I answered that. Okay. No more question. Huda, عندك شيء إضافة؟
حاليا لا.
Okay. Another question. How are we able to access legal or regulatory issues boundaries? Do you have in-house expert or is there a portal? Regulatory issues boundaries. Your task when you are studying the market, you are supposed to see regulatory issues and boundaries. Actually, in Oman, there is no portal to review regulatory issues. It is scattered. We have some boundaries. We have some regulations. Is published with Ministry of Legal Affairs. Some boundaries in IT published in MTC. Some boundaries are with the TRA, Telecommunication Regulation Authority. So please, don't think about the boundaries now. If there is any boundaries, we will raise it with you. While we are discussing the project idea, even within these 3 months, we will raise it with you. We have a good experience where we see where boundaries and regulations are blocking. For example, video conference call. I think everyone know that TRA is blocking video conferencing call before Corona. Now they allow these video conferencing calls only during Corona issue. We are expecting TRA to block any video conferencing call if it is not approved. They approve only now one solution for Omani company, but you can work in Oman Summer of Code now for the next 3 months with video call, for example, project. But you need to know that you will need a license at the end from TI. I hope I answer your question. Okay, any other question, سؤال, أي حاجة؟ تفاصيل زيادة تريدوها عن المشروع؟ إحنا مستعدين. هدى بالنسبة للاجتماعات. هل بتفتحي المجال للاجتماعات قبل ما يعملوا سبميت حال أفكار المشاريع؟
اجتماعات
إذا حد يريد اجتماع.
اجتماعات إيش قصدك؟
إذا يريد يمكن يقول لك أنا أريد أجتمع معكم بفريق مال الوزارة عشان أناقش فكرة المشروع قبل ما أسلمها رسميا.
ممكن عادي ما عندنا مشكلة. بس
التايم لاين كم هدى؟ Okay, كم التايم لاين مع حال submitting the project idea? 2 weeks.
عندهم أسبوعين بداية من الأسبوع الجاي واللي بعده إن شاء الله يكونوا okay. خلاص سلموا البروبوزل ويكونوا كونوا التيم مالهم.
Okay. I will say it again.
يعني
if you want to meet us as a team from MTC, from the ministry, before you submit officially your project idea, please contact us either now. It will be mainly Zulip chat or maybe through the email. Of course, we don't recommend the email, but before 3 days at least. So if you want to meet us on Thursday, don't ask for appointment on Wednesday. يعني please. And when we say three days, it means 3 working days. If you want to meet us on Sunday, don't send your request on Wednesday or Thursday, because Friday and Saturday is a weekend. So we will need the time to give you appointment and video call time to meet and discuss with you your project idea. I hope this is clear. هدى 3D شيء كنتي طيبة؟
لا بس بغيت أخبرهم تاريخ 18 جون 18 of June يكون هو آخر وقت لتسليم البروبوزل deadline.
Okay 18th June I will write it in the chat.
أيوة June, مدة أسبوعين وبيكون تاريخ 18 هو آخر يوم.
So first deadline for submitting your project idea and proposal. Okay. من نمشي شافوه. Okay. بالنسبة لحورية البوسعيدي تسأل ممكن تخبرونا عن بعض المشاريع السابقة. أنا براويك عن مشاريع شغالة. So هدى انا تشوفي البراوزر مالي؟
ايوه.
اوكي سو الجماعه حوريه طبعا تشتغل عن اكزامبل. This is one successful example. Start with Oman Summer of Code 2014 يعني في 2014 before 6 years. مزاد عمان is a platform مثل من اسمه platform for online auctions مزادات الكترونيه. الفكرة المشروع هذه جاية من شرطة عمان السلطانية. هم اللي طلبوا المشروع. نفذوها 3 من المشاركين معنا في صيف عمان للبرمجة. فازوا بدعم من الوزارة. دعم مالي. أسسوا الشركة مالهم. المشروع يعني أصبح أونلاين بعد سنة كاملة من التطوير. يعني تطويرهم في صيف عمان للبرمجة 3 أشهر كانت وكأنها بروتوتايب. تثبت انهم عندهم المقدره انهم يعملوا السوليوشن هذا. لكن احتاجوا سنه كامله. طبعا معظم هذيك السنه كامله كانت استثمارات في ما يخص السكيورتي للسيستم والاونلاين بيمنت وغيرها. فمزاد عمان هذا واحد من الامثله اللي يعني الحين شغاله كسوليوشن. اوكي الواحد الثاني اي ترانس اعتقد عندهم ويب سايت اي ترانس عمان. اعتقد انكم سمعتوا عن اي ترانس من قبل. هذا المشروع تطبيق في الهاتف للدليفري التوصيل الباكجز. طبعا التطبيق الحين تقدروا تنزلوه انتم من اندرويد وش اسمه والاي او اس. والجماعة هذين البروتوتايب مال المشروع كانوا يشتغلوا فيه في صيف عمان للبرمجة 2017. المشروع أصبح أونلاين تقريبا في منتصف 2018 مع التدشين الرسمي ماله. طبعا في الباك جراوند السوليوشن هذا جالس يشتغل بالأوبن سورس. كل اللي تشوفوا هذا كله أوبن سورس اللي يستخدموا فيه العمانية. اتمنى انه حوريه هذه النماذج يعني كافيه الا اذا كان في شيء ثاني. احمد العجمي one question out of The technical concerns. Are we expecting official certificates at the end of the program? Yes. After you complete Oman Summer of Code, you will receive a certificate from the ministry showing that you participate in Oman Summer of Code for the 3 months. Anonymous attendee. What if the idea was rejected? Wallahi, as I said, we are not rejecting ideas, but we are giving challenges and comments on them. If you take it, that's your يعني, decision. If you not, also it's your decision. But we recommend before you submit your project idea, at least to discuss it with us. In Zulip chat, for example, you can discuss it with us and we will give you our opinion if we go ahead or not. Okay, are we good to go now? Yes, you are good to go if you want. Yeah. We finish the session unless you have question. Is there will be prizes for the winners? Huda. اعتقد انت تكلمتي امس الموضوع
ايوه انا تكلمت امس وفي الاعلان اللي طلع في السوشيال ميديا كان واضح البرايسز اللي بيحصلوها ان شاء الله الفرق الفائزه راح تحصل دعم مالي انها تحضر انترناشونال ايفنت في فوس خارج السلطنه ان شاء الله لكل الفريق يعني للثري ممبرز في الفريق الواحد بيحصلوا كلهم هذا الدعم كل تيم التيم الواحد راح يحصل دعم واحد لانهم يبداوا البزنس مالهم يعني يشتغلوا على الشركه مالهم اسسوا شركه صغيره من فئات الشركات الصغيره والمتوسطه طبعا في اشتراطات انكم انتم تحصلوا هذا الدعم انكم لازم يعني في هذيك الفترة راح نخبركم ايش البروسيس عشان تحصلوا الدعم ان شاء الله.
اوكي انا I will repeat it in English. The prizes for Oman Summer of Code. All team members who win we will select best three team members. They will get a fund to attend open source conference outside Oman. Mostly احنا we select one conference in Singapore. And you will get also fund as a team to establish your company. You should know in 2019, we have three winners, three team members. They got the fund to attend the conference in Singapore, but of course they didn't go because of Corona. So they got the money. They got the fund also to establish the company, but only one team utilized that fund. I don't know why. But only one team utilizes it. The other team, they said your terms and conditions are maybe complicated. I don't know. This is the answer. Anonymous attendee.
بالإضافة للtechnical experience والbusiness experience اللي حصلوها طبعاً من البرنامج.
إن شاء الله. Okay, as you have been running maybe the program for more than 5 years, can you tell us what are the main barriers for the team not pursuing business setup? Wallahi, this is a difficult question. The main barriers which I see, this is my personal only thought, it is the team understanding, يعني, with capabilities, with skills. It is the team. They consider Oman Summer of Code like a competition only. Yani everyone who participates in Oman Summer of Code, they consider it a competition. In the ministry, we don't use competition name. We say Oman Summer of Code is a program. You are having a program to enhance your technical skills in open source. You understand the business side of open source. You will understand the barriers, what is happening in the market in Oman, from the industry, from government and private sector, the challenges. You will understand that it's not easy, of course, to start your business. Mainly, what is the barrier which I see is the team members, actually. So you need to يعني have actually the objective from now. Are you planning to start your business after Oman Summer of Code or not? If not, it's fine for us. يعني we don't force you to open a business. But you will get, of course, enhancing your skills technically and also from the business side. Okay, the other questions. You said yesterday that we will not build our project from scratch. How? What do you mean, actually? Okay, what do I mean? I will give you an example. So you can see my now, what is called the browser. You know, I hope you, everyone knows what is WordPress. Yani this solution, I think now even kids are playing with it. So WordPress is open source solution, content management system. What is in Oman Summer of Code, you will have an idea, for example, to build a website for an organization. Let's assume you will build a website for us, for Ministry of Technology and Communications. We are not expecting you to install Linux, then MySQL, then Apache, then PHP, then you will start adding pages by PHP from scratch. No, we don't expect you to do that. There are open source tools which make your life easy. One of them is WordPress. WordPress is widely used to build websites. Why you don't use WordPress? So I will show you a sample of what WordPress can be used for. So this page is our open source conference page built using WordPress. All the things you see now in this website was built by Omani, two girls actually. Within 3 months, they did everything for us. And actually they did a great job. So WordPress is running this website from the back end. So this is one example, which I mean that you don't need to do your project from scratch. This is only one example. أنا اللي أقوله إنه ما تبدأ كل حاجة من الصفر خاصة مع الأوبن سورس. وطبعاً إذا قلت إن أنا ببدأ بالصفر بنعطيك هذا الملاحظة من البداية وبنقول لك إيش التشالنجز اللي بتلاحظها. Okay, if the project is successful but we don't prepare the project to go alive during these 3 months, we will continue to support till finished and go alive the project. Going alive for the project is not the objective of Oman Summer of Code. We are not expecting you to go alive with the project unless you are extremely mashallah doing excellent job. So we are expecting prototype running solution. And you can answer our questions, mainly technical and business side. Supporting you after the program, we cannot say no, but we cannot also promise to support you after the program. It will depend actually on the load on us. Bint Mariam, okay. I hope I'm pronouncing the name correctly. How will we be assigned mentors? It will be given by you? No, mentors are optional. As we said, it is through your network, maybe one from your family members or someone you know it from the industry, from government, from private sector to support you. So we are not assigning mentors to you. The mentors which you are getting now is actually supervisors from the ministry, which is me, Huda, and our colleague Fahd. Fahd now is on leave, but mainly you will deal with me with me and Huda during this program. Mentors, we recommend you to have mentors to understand the industry requirements and issues. Okay, Muhammad Al-Haddabi, assuming someone will develop a web app as their project, does it need to be published an online server or it's working locally is enough. It's enough. Hadabi, you can put it locally. We don't recommend, يعني we don't request you to put it on server online. This is in short. Any other question? Because we need to close this session after 10 minutes, 10:30. So we are, you are stuck with us for the next 10 minutes. If you have any question, please put it now in the chat. Okay. Nothing. Okay. Thank you. Thank you, Aflah. If anyone have any question, you can put it. We can wait. يعني for okay. We have one question. What is the aim of using Linux since we are using other open source program? The question is not clear, but Linux is the operating system. يعني احنا we want you to use Linux only, as I said, to make your life difficult. And this is your own, this is what we know. This is the only chance for you to explore Linux. If you are not using it for the next 3 months, when we will use it يعني, and explore Linux. Why we are pushing Linux? Linux operating system is dominating actually the infrastructure. So يعني, as IT, anyone, IT graduate, IT specialist, if he doesn't deal with Linux, he missed like 80% of IT. This is how I see it. يعني. So Linux, you are forced to use it. يعني. Any other question? Okay, Amir Dagheshi, which is better, business project or services only for community or for government? Money versus free. Note, we need job and money. Amir, there is nothing called better. يعني. Business project with services for the community or government are having different يعني, business models. You cannot say that if you are having a project for government, you are assured that you will get the money and the job from it. يعني. And you can build business around it. It's not like that. Even for charity now, if you want to build a project for charity organization, ما على سبيل المثال جمعية الرحمة, I think everyone knows جمعية الرحمة, charity هذا. They need ERP solution. They need a financial solution. They need IT solutions, and they are ready to pay. They will pay for you. Yes, they will not pay like big organization like government and big companies, but they will pay at the end. The issue that with these charity, الجمعيات هذه, no one is talking to them. ولذلك يعني it is difficult to يعني for them also to move. Usually they don't have IT people. يعني. فاحنا we recommend your project idea or your project proposal. You study what is happening in Oman and the region. And you will see. Okay, سعيد السلطي. باقي آلية التواصل واختيار أعضاء الفريق إذا ممكن تفيدونا. سعيد, يعني أنا تكلمت في هذا الموضوع. بيوصلك إيميل من زولب تشات للجميع. بتعمل يوزر نيم باسورد. بتدخل هذا السوفت وير, بتشوف كل المشاركين هنا مثل ما انا تشوف الحين اليوزرز. تقدر تكلمهم في الجروب هذا اللي اسمه جنرال. بنعمل توبيك نسميه احنا جروب, فورم جروب على سبيل المثال, وتقدر تتواصل مع الجميع هنا وتقول لهم ان انا محتاج شخص مثلا بهذا السكيلز وغيره, بيرد عليك الشخص المناسب. تعملوا ويش اسمه فيديو كول, ترسل له رقم موبايلك, ترسل له ايميلك, الديسكشن كلها بتكون في هذا البلاتفورم. اتمنى انه يعني واضح الرد هذا. اذا كان طبعا البلاتفورم ما كافيه بنشوف حل ثاني, بس الحين هنشوف ان البلاتفورم هذا كافي. Okay, عندنا 5 دقائق, 5 minutes left. If you have any question, anything in general. هدى انت بدأتي ترسلي الفايلات من أمس ولا بعده؟
لا لا بعده برسلهم مرة واحدة ناوي إن شاء الله اليوم بس نخلص الريكوردد سيشن ونرسلهم إياها
إن شاء الله. زين ما عليه, احنا جالسين بعدنا 5 دقائق لحد ما إذا حد عنده أي سؤال.
بس نأكد عليكم إنه ما حد يرسل إيميلات للإيفنت تيم معنا في الوزارة لأنه المشروع والتيم إحنا مختصين فيه فرسلوا لنا إحنا عن طريق زلب أفضل طبعاً أو عن طريق الإيميل.
أوكي طبعاً أنت هدى بترسلي لهم إيميل فيما يخص البروجكت أيديا والديدلاين ماله صح؟ هذاك بعدين
البروبوزل
أيوة.
أيوة حتى برسلهم تامبلت.
Okay, so there is a question. There has been businesses that came out of Oman Summer of Code that targeted government. However, out of them, have they sold their solutions to international markets? And is there support for this from the ministry? No. This is the short answer for this. There is no support from the ministry. Don't expect. That we will support you to sell your solution either locally in the government or internationally. This is your business, your solution, your project. What we can do is to facilitate only, to give you hints only. Okay, what is the next step? Next step, you will receive a bunch of emails from our site. And with all the content which we discussed yesterday and today, you will receive invitation mail from Zulib platform. Everyone needs to join Zulib chat. We will stop using emails. يعني maybe starting from next week, we will stop using emails. We will need you to discuss everything in this platform. And then we will give you 2 weeks, starting from next Sunday, to have your team ready, the project idea, the proposal, and then we will have our first evaluation after 2 weeks. I hope I am clear. Okay. Thanks. Okay. Any other question? For the participants which are expats, not Omanis, you need to know that the condition in Oman Summer of Code say clearly, if you form a team from expats, 50% of the member of this team should be Omanis. So if you are one expat, someone which doesn't have Omani nationality, if you are one, you need to bring one Omani with you. If you are two, we will accept. It's fine for us to bring another one Omani, so you will be three. We recommend to have two Omani, one expat or one expat, one Omani, two expats, one Omani. It's fine. Can we send more than one proposal? No, please. يعني, you cannot send more than one proposal. It is one project, one idea, one proposal. But you can discuss with us before submitting the project. It's fine. You say to us, either now through Zulib, that I want to meet you to discuss multiple ideas. And then we can give you our opinion. Okay, 2 minutes more for questions. Any question, anything?
الظاهر ما في أسئلة زيادة خليل
الله اوكي How are you? Fine. Okay, so the Mohammed Al-Haddabi, mashallah alik, enta fi akhir lahza. So the proposal will only accepted once, even if it needed some changes. Yes, it's fine. If some changes needed, we will give you the feedback about the proposal. Yani, we are not expecting perfect proposal, to be honest, yani, Mohammed. Okay. Any other question? Then we are closing now the session. Thank you, everyone. You will receive yani, a lot of emails coming from our side. Then you will need to join our group yani, discussion in Zolib chat. And have yani, a nice journey with us, inshallah, in this Oman Summer of Code 2020 video. Thank you.